And we welcome you inside Gangneung Ice Arena for day three of the figure skating competition, day three of the team event. Medals on the line today. This is how things stand. Five countries left. It's Canada on top. Olympic athletes from Russia. The U.S. could overtake that second spot, but they have to hold off Italy, who look to charge from fourth place. Team boxes are filled up with teammates and coaches getting ready. We've got the men, the ladies, and the dancers today, and the men on the ice warming up already, including the 28-year-old from Clark Summit, Pennsylvania, Adam Rippon. It hasn't happened overnight. It took 18 years of skating and three Olympic cycles for him to finally make the team, but he is here and he is more than ready.
I have had this dream since I first stepped onto the ice. There were a lot of times where I was like, you know what, I just don't think it's gonna happen. But third time's a charm, baby. You never see me with the white flag waving.
You think I'm backing down, you're mistaken. Go ahead and own the ice, why don't you, Adam Rippon? There's a reaction.
Competition at the Olympics is fierce. My goal is to have this sneak attack. If the guys trying the really hard elements slip up, boom, there's Adam Rippon out of nowhere. How confident am I? I am very confident. And I'm the full-grown monster I'm supposed to be. I'm so proud of myself for everything that I've done and everything that I'm still going to do. There's a warrior inside of me.
Bold, outspoken, tongue-in-cheek at times. He makes you watch him. You can't turn away. Terry Gannon getting set along with Tara Lipinski and Johnny Weir. You guys set, guys?
We're ready.
Oh, yeah.
There you go. Adam Rippon out there just leaving the ice right now. You've got five skaters here in the men's event. So Rippon is there, a great opportunity. But also Mikail Kolyada from Russia, who really needs to make amends. He had a terrible short program. And Patrick Chan, former world champ from Canada, also in the mix here. The men, the ladies, and the dance. We saw the pairs free skate yesterday, last time around. This is only the second time for the team event. It was Russia, Canada, the U.S. And now it's Canada. The
first
Olympic
to skate.
Athletes from Russia and the
Olympic
U.S.
athlete from Russia.
Russia 출신 올림픽 선수.
Mikhail Kolyada.
So taking the ice first here in the free skate, the 22-year-old from St. Petersburg, Russia, Mikhail Kolyada, a two-time Russian champ, European bronze medalist the last couple of seasons. So one of those who expected to come here and really be a contender, but eighth place in that short program. Here he is with the free skate trying to help out Russia.
His short program single-handedly put Russia out of contention with a disastrous skate. He's really needing to bring it back here in the free skate. And he could do that with this quad lutz. Missed it again.
Tripling out on a planned quad toe loop there. In the current judging system, it's better to rotate and fall than to do the easier triple or double that most skaters pop into. Pop is a slang that we use to say when you don't complete the rotation. The reason that is the base value for a quad is much higher than that of a triple, even if it's fallen off.
We'll be right back.
hasn't been on his game in practice. He's looked off, kind of sluggish. He has a beautiful technique to his jump, especially the quad lutz when he hits it. We just haven't seen it. But he has another shot at a quad toe coming up. It'll be in the second half, and that means you get a 10% bonus.
His jumps. It's just about consistency for him and keeping his head focused on the competition at hand.
As Johnny, as we have been talking about, he's one of the best jumpers here. I feel like he needs one of those self-driving cars when he goes into his quad lutz because he's thinking way too hard about
it. To get
it
going.
Just
a little cruise control.
Yeah, he just has to go into muscle memory, and he's not doing that.
With so many of the skaters, we talk about how important it is to get out here, be a part of the team event before the individual event. But when you're not skating well, could it do some harm? A guy like Kolyada, perhaps that is the case. Although the second half of the program, he did turn it on.
He brought it back.
Yep, came back. Such a deep lineup for the ladies in Russia, not so much for the men. Kolyada going to get his numbers in a moment. The opener here in the men.
That's Italy.
Mikail Kolyada just
Matteo.
Leaving the team area right now. 173.57. So about 12 points under his personal best, but that's the standard set here in men's free skate. And